In this tutorial, we'll give you a quick overview of the Edit workspace. When you open PaintShop Pro, you'll see three workspace tabs at the top. Manage for managing your photo library, Adjust for making quick corrections, and Edit for accessing the full set of image editing tools. Let's tour the Edit workspace, which has several menus, toolbars, a tool options palette, a preview area, a learning center, and several default palettes that include materials, layers, and the organizer. The navigation palette is not visible, but it can be easily and temporarily accessed from the organizer palette here. Click the navigation button again to hide it. The Learning Center can be very useful for new or experienced users. If you're wondering how to complete a task, such as straightening an image, start at the home location and choose Quick Adjustments, then click Straighten. Simply follow the instructions to complete the task. I'll show you other ways the Learning Center can be very helpful later in this video. In the meantime, I'll use the Auto Hide feature to hide the Learning Center and make more room to work on other images. With the original and edited version of my photo, I now have two open images that can be viewed and accessed several different ways. Tabbed view is the default, which fills the screen with only the currently selected image. Simply switch documents by selecting a tab at the top. You might also prefer a non-tabbed view. That can be changed from the window menu. This view lets me view more than one image at a time, so I can compare my before and after images side by side. Although PaintShop Pro has many of the professional level features you'd expect in a much more expensive image editing application, such as white balance, curves, histograms, level adjustments, and more, there are also some very cool special features you might not expect, such as skin smoothing, backlighting, fill flash, and distortion corrections. One of my favorites is the Selective Focus feature found under the Effects, Photo Effects menu. Selective Focus is similar to the Depth of Field feature, but it can be used to create images that simulate almost toy-like environments. This tilt-shift effect is very popular on TV. With increased color saturation, you can create a dramatic landscape. Here is a good place to show how easy it is to add text. Let me select the text tool in the toolbar. If you recall, I last used the Learning Center to determine which tool to use to straighten a picture. Upon reopening the Learning Center palette, I can now use it to see instructions on the tool that I've just selected. Even though you may already know how to use a tool, the Learning Center can provide you with helpful tips you may not be aware of. The Layers palette can also be a very useful feature. Layers let you separate edits so you can change a layer without affecting the contents of other layers. Some layers are created automatically. Notice the text I created was automatically placed on a new layer. Layer styles are effects that can be added to an individual layer. Here I can add effects such as a nice drop shadow and maybe even a bevel to my text layer. This video has just touched on the possibilities of the PaintShop Pro Edit workspace. If you need more information, check out the PaintShop Pro help files or explore the Corel guide for additional resources and tutorials. In the next video, we'll take you on a tour of the new PaintShop Pro Places feature that lets you use maps and location information to view, find, and organize your photos according to where your photos were taken.